Welcome to our AER Commuter Brief 2 review. We've reviewed a lot of premium messengers slash briefs on this channel, some noteworthy ones being the Nomadic Messenger and the Peak Design Messenger, but they're pretty pricey at around $200+. Is the AER Commuter Brief a good mid-range alternative? We're about to tell you. Welcome to Nomads Nation. I'm Aaron, he's Tav, and we do the best travel gear reviews on the web. This review is split into different sections so you can jump to the part that you're most interested in. And if you dig backpacks and messengers and travel gear, hit the subscribe button, hit the notification bell, and nuke that like button. Just obliterate that button. We're gonna start this review with the overall pros and the cons of the AER Commuter Brief 2. That way you can eat your steak before your veggies. Pro number one is going to be the amazing features and organization of the front pocket. Pro number two is going to be the sleek look. You're probably looking for a messenger because you're looking for a business savvy carrying solution. And pro number three, I just love the way that it stands up by itself. Super solid, not gonna fall over. Muy importante. But flip side, let's talk about some of the cons. Con number one, the shoulder strap's a bit too short for my taste. You'll find out exactly what I mean in the comfort section. And con number two is that I think that this back button pocket here is a little on the pointless side. And con number three is going to be the AER jingle. It's like Santa's sleigh. Still here? Nice. Let's really tear this brief apart, but first, please hit the like button. Do you do it? I think you did it. Awesome, let's go. Okay, now let's get into the nitty gritty, and we're gonna talk about the specs of the AER Commuter Brief 2. The ultimate gist of this is that it's a brief mixed with a messenger, kind of a briefinger, have you. For color options, you got one, the black. The capacity is 13 liters, which is pretty average for a messenger. You wouldn't want it too much bigger. And if it was any smaller, you wouldn't be able to fit most of your gear. The weight is 2.9 LBS, and the price comes in at around $145. All right, next up, we're gonna talk about the style. It's mature, it's professional, it's sleek. Tab hates it when I say sleek. And that's good because if you're looking for a messenger, it's probably because you're looking for something that's more professional. And that's what the style is. It's like this like sleek, leathery sort of external material with the robust yet smooth Cordura ballistic nylon. Ultimately, this thing's got it going on. It looks good. Okay, now let's chat about some of the materials of the AER Commuter Brief 2. Let's start with the exterior materials. This material right here is an 840D nylon with a polyurethane coating. I can never say that. It's got a smooth, leathery feel to it. And obviously due to the coating, it's going to be highly water resistant. But the rest of the exterior material is going to be this guy right here, which is ballistic nylon made from Cordura. Cordura nylon is durable. They make like bulletproof vests with this thing. For zippers, they're all YKK, but interesting note, not water resistant or PU coated, just regular YKK zips. Hardware is done by Duraflex, a very reputable company. Great hardware. And for the interior materials, I don't know exactly what these are. We think it's probably some sort of nylon. When it comes to materials, AER usually does the same sort of game. They spall out on their exterior materials. These are quality. And then on the interior, they're like, we can cut a few corners here, right? I'm not saying that the interior materials are bad. They're just not as premium as the exterior materials. Okay, now let's talk about the comfort. Very important chapter, section, thing to talk about. If I did have a major point of criticism, it would be with the comfort, with the messenger style, because it's a real short, like, leash, man. Like, I'm a short dude, I'm 5'8", and this is up to the top of my torso. But I like my messenger to go a little bit lower. I like it to be like waistline. But this right here is as low as it goes. And like I said, I'm a short dude, so if you're a taller dude or dudette, then it might creep up even further on your body and therefore f-ing with the overall comfort. It's a very important thing to keep into consideration. Now, if you're like, dude, I'm not really into like the cross sling sort of mode, I just wanna wear it this way, then you're gonna be very pleased because the comfort is fantastic, whether you wanna go into like one shoulder mode or whether you wanna go into full brief mode. For one shoulder mode, that's because this padding, like most AER products, is absolutely just a cloud, dude. Like, AER makes sleek products, but they make comfy products. Onto the actual handle. Not really any padding there, but you don't really need it in a Messenger. There's a good amount of grip, and it's not too rough as to where it's painful. And some of you may have noticed here on the handle, we've got this little clip system. And if you're anything like me, you're gonna be like, dude, that don't look comfortable. But it's surprisingly is fine. Overall, carrying it as a brief is a very comfortable experience. The only criticism that I have for the comfort is if you wanna go sort of crossbody, this dude is like up here. All right, let's get into this bad boy. Let's talk about the front of this commuter brief. Some quick bullet points for this section. We've got the exterior materials, AER's very subtle logo and branding, and a front pocket that is an organizer's dream come true. Let's talk about it. Before we get to the inside, let's chat about the outside. This PU coated nylon right here, like I said, big fan of the way that it looks. I also like the wrinkly factor. I think the wrinkliness adds like kind of like a hipster cool vibe. From there, we have AER's super subtle branding. If you're the kind of person who doesn't like a big logo on your Messenger, then AER's branding should be right up your alley. But let's get into the actual main front compartment, which in my opinion is one of the standout features of this bag. The zipper pulls are AER's typical zipper pulls. They're cool because they're kind of like anti-theft, so you can just loop them into each other, do one of these. It's not gonna completely stop a thief, but it can just help provide a little extra peace of mind. One thing to note about AER's zippers is some people absolutely hate them because, you hear that? Hear that jingle? That little AER jingle right there? It's a thing. The comment, "I hate AER's jingly zippers," ends up more on my YouTube channel than I ever would have thought. Big chunky YKK zippers, not PU coated, so it's an easier opening experience, but it's not gonna be waterproof. And then we get into this organizational masterpiece, the front compartment. This might look familiar to you. You're like, oh, this looks like other AER products' inner compartments. And that's because it basically is a carbon copy of AER's front compartments and their other products. Let's look at what I packed here. I got my shades in this pocket here. Got a pen in the pen pocket. Crazy, right? Who would have thought? Got my AirPods. I use this pocket usually for like tissues and mints. Got my keys in this little zip pocket right here on the key leash. And then I've got a Moleskine notebook in the little notebook compartment here. A lot of these pockets are similar, just sort of an elastic band at the top and made with a nylon material. Really nice elasticity here. And because, and like I said, because of this wrinkly design, if you do want to pack more gear there, it can accommodate that. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4 pockets here, two of which are pen pockets. Moving to the other side, we have a stretchy pocket that looks like mesh. Like, that's clearly a mesh pocket. It is definitely not mesh, but it's a little bit bigger. You can fit a lot more gear in there. This could also be a good thing for like a laptop charger, maybe a bigger pair of headphones. A little further north, we have the zip pocket. No additional organization here. It's just a basic pocket, but you do have the keyring solution. If you watch my videos, you know I'm a big fan of good keyring solutions. This one's a good one. Why, you might ask? Well, because you're walking home, long day at work, blasting Denzel Curry on the headphones, you wanna get into your front door, you don't have to worry about fighting for your keys because they are right here. Oh, love that. And yeah, good point. It's like literally straight at the level of the doorknob. It's just door ready. It's just like open f-ing sesame. And then the last compartment is right here, which is the entire depth, basically, of the front compartment. This is a good place for things like notebooks. I always like to keep like maybe a backup tote here, hashtag no plastics. But it's a pretty versatile pocket and it expands a bit so you can fit a decent amount of stuff in there. I emphasize again, I love this front pocket. It might be more organization and features than the average Joe needs, but if you got a lot of tidbits that you like to organize, this is your guy. Okay, let's move on to the middle. Some bullet points. We'll talk about the strap system, the top handles, and a fairly large main compartment. Let's get into it. The good news is that if you're like, you know what, the Messenger thing, I don't want it. I just want to go into brief mode. I don't need that Messenger bag. No problem, dude. Duraflex has got you covered. A nice, easy removal system, easy to pop on, easy to pop off. And then kaboom, you're completely in brief mode. The strap itself is mostly made from basic nylon webbing. And the materials help also give it a nice breathability and ventilation. The top handles, we covered most of it. I'll take two handles on my briefcase over one handle any day of the week. It just gives you a little bit more like, where are you going? Nowhere. And if you want to ensure a tidier experience, just go ahead and clip this on and boom, they're stuck together. Now let's get into the main compartment. Now it's the same YKK zips, same sort of locking system. Let's see what I got inside. I have a Lululemon jacket. I love Lululemon. Water bottle. And then I got a tech pouch in there. This is my new Belroy tech pouch. Pretty badass. The review's coming for this soon. So as opposed to the front compartment, which has lots of pockets and organization, this one's a bit simpler. We've got a water bottle holder on this side right here. Note about the water bottle holder. I'm glad that it's there, but it's a little bit difficult to get your water bottle in sometimes. For reference, this is a 520 milliliter hydro flask. Nice tight fit. I wouldn't recommend going probably bigger than a 600. It probably wouldn't fit. Now, located behind the water bottle pocket, there is a zipper pocket right there, and it just has a plastic panel. This helps to give the brief a little bit more structure. Moving on to the back panel, we've got two compartments. Regular compartment, laptop compartment. The regular one is actually surprisingly rough, the material. Even Tav was like, dude, what the, it's really rough. But I think it's good for maybe a book. Mouse pad, Bluetooth keyboard, yeah, good idea, good idea. And then finally, the laptop compartment. This setup is commonly used in other Air packs. It's a really nice material, soft to the touch, and a little bit of cushion to it. It's not really suspended as much as I would like, but you got about, you got a bit. And one last note about the middle is you can see on the bottom how Air has implemented this sort of like plastic system here. And it's great for one reason and one reason only. It can stand up by itself. I love this. Huge selling point for me with the messenger bag. The Nomadic Messenger does this. The Peak Design kind of sorta does this, but this guy is always gonna be standing up, and for a briefcase, that is very important. Now, last section, let's talk about the back of this brief. 3 points, we got a luggage pass-through holder, zipper pocket right here, and a larger pocket, which is accessible by a button. Let's talk about the button pocket. I personally kind of find this entire compartment to be, what's the word, pointless? I just never used it. It's like, they're like, oh, you know who needs this compartment is people who have documents and papers and newspapers. And I don't know if you're gonna actually use it because I never did. It might work for a book, maybe something you want a little bit quicker access to, but not my favorite compartment on this bag. Next up, we have the kind of hidden pocket right here. YKK zip, smoothing zipping experience, padded materials, really soft, and I think it's a good spot for your wallet. Reason being, you're carrying the brief on your side, it's here, your body sort of shields this area. So I got my wallet in there. And then the final point is that we have a luggage pass-through holder. It's secured by Velcro, which I think is okay for the price range of the pack. And if you are flying somewhere and you have a roller luggage and you want to slide this guy on, you will use it. And if you never do, then you will completely forget about its existence. That's it. Okay, now let's talk about who the AER Commuter Brief 2 is for and who I think can take a pass on it. I think the commuter brief is for you is, you know, as the name suggests, you're a commuter who needs a brief. If you travel to and from work on a daily basis and you're looking for something that is functional but also has a clean and professional look to it, I don't think it gets any better than this. If that sounds like you and you're gonna make a purchase, please use the first link in the description. That link makes sure that you get the best price and it helps to support our channel. It's also gonna be the brief slash messenger for you if you're looking for a brief slash messenger that doesn't cost like $220 US. At around 140 USD, this comes in at a more moderate price range without really sacrificing much, to be honest. Like head to head with the Nomadic, which is like 70 US dollars more, I think I would maybe take this guy. If that sounds like you and you're gonna make a purchase, please use the link in the description. Thank you. But on the flip side, see what their flip side, so I flipped it over. You get it. Here's who I think should consider looking into alternatives. I don't know if this guy's gonna be perfect for you if you have a very specific digital nomad setup. I'm talking about you've got the Bluetooth mouse and the Bluetooth keyboard, the gaming laptop, the crypto rig, the freaking Roost laptop stand. Like, you're just like super, super techie and you've got lots of bulkier tech gear. I think that you should look into the Nomatic Messenger bag. Check it out. It's not quite as comfortable as this guy, but the tech organization I think is superior. Take a look in the description. We have a link to the review down there. Also, I think you might be able to take a pass on this if you're looking for like a messenger that is more DSLR friendly. Ultimately, you can fit a camera in the AER Commuter Brief too, but it's not designed for photographers. And there are amazing messengers that are specifically designed for photographers. Take a look at the links below. I've got a review to a few messengers down there that I think that would be perfect for you. And one more person who might be interested in taking a pass on this is if you don't need a 13 liter. Ultimately, this can fit a lot of stuff, but if you're just like, dude, I got a laptop, a charger, a pen, a notebook, and like a pack of gum, and that's it. This is gonna be too big for you. I've got a different AER product. It's not quite a brief messenger, but it's like a sling messenger. And I just think it's really cool. And you should consider watching our review. It's in the link in the description. Check it out. Guys, thanks so much for sticking around for the entirety of this video. If you're still here, it probably means that you haven't made up your mind yet. So like I said, I definitely recommend watching the reviews to our other messengers. You can find those links in the description. The more reviews you watch, the better idea and understanding you'll have of what messenger or brief fits your specific needs. And also, if you found this video useful, it would mean the world to us if you could hit the subscribe button and the notification bell, hit the like button, and let us know any other questions that you have. Or if you own this commuter brief, because a lot of people watch these reviews when they already own it because they're trying to understand more about the product that they bought, then let us know in the comments what you think. Is the shoulder strap too short? I think it is. Is this pocket as useless as I think it is? Let us know in the comments below, and we'll see you guys next time. Bye. Nothing there? Okay.